From the basement of La Penta, this is WICR.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Sports Vault. I'm your host with the most, Jersey Joe Arcino, and I lied. I said I was done with soccer. I said I wasn't talking any more soccer, but let's be all honest. You all understood. I wasn't done talking soccer. Cannot believe that I almost forgot to break down NYCFC getting a... Look, it wasn't a win. But I think when we look at it in the grand scheme of things for NYCFC, it's as good as a win. Getting a draw against the Chicago Fire on Friday, 2-2. I was at the game covering it. It was a very, very nice one to go to. Beautiful to watch a game Friday night on a nice May in Yankee Stadium. And look, NYCFC is down 2-0 early. They're down a man, playing without a man for basically the entire match. I think in the 26th minute is when they went down a man. And to come back and respond with two goals, I think Jason Christ, head coach of NYCFC, I think he said it was one of the most special moments of his coaching career. To me, that's very telling because Jason Christ is a guy who's virtually had success everywhere he's ever been in the MLS. And for him to say that, dude, this was one of the most special moments of his coaching career, coming back and drawing it with 2-2 after being down a man and conceding two goals early. I think that's very telling to me. And obviously the highlight of it was the man of the match, Kyrie Shelton, scoring the tying goal, his first goal of the season. Now, I'm going to be honest. I think Kyrie is one of those guys. The moment I saw him come on the pitch for the first time for NYCFC, he kind of had a special feeling about this guy. And obviously, he's their draft pick in the MLS draft, and he's a phenomenal player. He's an even better guy. I mean, I'm lucky enough to cover the team, and he's just a super guy. I know he's one of the fan favorites, and rightfully so. He's just a really good dude. Really always enjoy talking to him, and I always wish him nothing but the best because he's just a really good player, and he's a really good guy off the pitch too. The kids, he takes the time to go and always take pictures. He's just always with a smile. Always with a smile, Kyrie Shelton. But it was really nice to see him get the first goal. A lot of questions were being asked of him about the confidence. What can this do for him? And one of the things I thought was very interesting was Jason Christ, where he was saying that He was in the same shoes as Kyrie Shelton. He had been in the same situation as him, so he knows how big of a difference maker this can be for him, how much it can help his confidence, and I think clearly that is big. I mean, you know it's going to help him out. Score, whenever you get that first goal out of the way, I feel like it brings so much of that anxiety away, and I think he knows he belongs. Kyrie Shelton has a very important place on this NYCFC team. They'd lost four matches before this. I mean, they were still winless in their last nine, but it's still, you erase the nine-game losing streak, and I think that in itself is a victory. You turn the page from here. You've got a lot of good things going your way. Kyrie Shelton gets his first goal. I think you saw the fight and the response, and the word Jason Christ used was effort. He talked about, look, this is what it's going to take every night from these guys to get results like this. And I think they feel like there's so much talent on this group, and there are some growing pains. Again, this is their first inaugural season as a franchise in the MLS. You know there's going to be some growing pains, but I think they're starting to figure things out. And clearly, Kyrie Shelton getting his first goal is a tremendous help. It's tremendous for the club, because if he starts getting those goals and he's becoming more of a lethal scorer, again, you've got to have confidence based merely on the fact that there's so many talented players on this group. I think the biggest frustration has been the timing hasn't been down. The chemistry hasn't been down. Things like that, which take time to build. I think once Frank Lampard arrives, it's hard not seeing them as a force. I mean, you're going to have David Villa and Frank Lampard, two of the legends of world football. Frank Lampard has played some meaningful minutes this year for Manchester City. David Villa is already one of the forces in this league. I think when guys like Kyrie Shelton and Mix and Ned Grabovoy and all of these players, Pablo Alvarez, Cuadro Poku, there is a lot to like with this NYCFC group. Again, I think a lot of it has come down to the chemistry has been difficult to build. It takes a lot of time. Clearly, the frustration was there. It's been real. I've been in that locker room so many times after these losses during this stretch where things were not going well, and you know it's eating up on them, but I feel like they're still always buying, and they need it. And this, I feel like, is the turning point that they needed. You just, I think all of us were just saying to ourselves, you've just got to get one. You've got to just turn the page from there. And I feel like this is the kind of victory they can turn the page from, especially from the standpoint of Kyrie Shelton finally getting that goal. That goal is symbolic, I think, of what NYCFC has gone through. It has been a tough adjustment. I think the Red Bulls game was the tipping point where they lose that match, especially with the Red Bulls playing with a man down and still dominating them in basically every conceivable way. I think that was as low as it could have gotten. That was the low point, and they finally have come back. This week is it. This is a very important test for them. Real Salt Lake against NYCFC. It's a 10 p.m. tip-off on the 23rd, so that's very important because then you come back home against the Houston Dynamo on the 31st. I should be at that one to cover it. But I think these next two are really, really important because you have that second rematch against the Red Bulls coming soon. Frank Lampard is on the horizon. I think things are starting to line up and even out for NYCFC, but you've got to see how they respond in this next match. This next match is huge for them. Kyrie Shelton's confidence level has got to be there, coming off of how well he played. David V, of course, is always there. I think you need to start to see the improvement, certainly, with their counterattack. And Joe D, one of our big soccer guys from Iona, doing great things at CBS, him and I are always talking about NYCFC. And that's one of the points that he made, that the counterattack has been incredibly disappointing. And I think he's spot on in that regard. And again, I think that's the same type of thing with the chemistry, building that kind of level, and the touch of the ball certainly hasn't been there yet. But I think those are all things that with time come, and I think clearly the time is coming. Now, you're going to need to start to see that improvement, but I think it all starts with getting that draw on Friday against the Chicago Fire. There's no way back from here. Again, I always say this. I said it about the Cleveland Cavaliers when they started going on this big winning streak this season in January, and it seemed like things were being figured out. There's no going back from here. You've shown it. You've got to continue to pay forward. There's room for a loss here and there, but for the most part, there's no going back. You have to continue to improve, to get the form, get the chemistry down. I saw on their Instagram page this morning, training. The training's huge. I mean, that's where you build the chemistry. The chemistry is clearly where NYCFC gets taken to the next level. Because again, the talent is there, and that's what the most frustrating thing is. There are so many good players on this team. There's a great coaching staff on this team. It's all coming down to building the chemistry, building the continuity, and being familiar with each other. Clearly, that is the next step, and we will see this weekend if that's what they can do against Real Salt Lake. A big test, but I think NYCFC, all eyes will be on them, and we'll see how they respond. But this is Jersey Joe Archino. I think this might be it for the day, but back tomorrow, folks. Signing off for the day.